Hey everyone, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to edit WordPress code. While WordPress makes it easy for non-coders to manage a website, there will probably come a time when you want to edit code in WordPress to get a little bit more control over how your site looks or functions. To help you do that, I will show you how to safely edit code in WordPress in a few different ways. Editing WordPress HTML for individual posts or pages, editing your theme's HTML and PHP code, and editing CSS. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, let's get editing. To get more control on how your WordPress site looks and functions, you can edit your WordPress code to customize different areas like individual posts or pages, a child theme source code, a theme's functions file or head section of the website, or you can add custom CSS in the additional CSS area in the WordPress customizer. Let's start off with the simplest way to edit WordPress HTML, accessing the source code for individual WordPress posts, pages, or other post types. You can do this in both the new WordPress Gutenberg block editor as well as the older classic editor. First, if you just want to add your own HTML code to a piece of content, I would recommend not trying to edit the entire source code of your post, as that makes things needlessly complicated. Instead, you can just use the dedicated custom HTML block and paste the code that you want to use there. However, there also might come a time where you need to directly edit the HTML of a different block. For example, if you want to add a nofollow tag to a link in the block editor, you need to edit the HTML of that block. There are two ways that you can do this. First, you can click on the options for an individual block and choose the Edit as HTML option. This will let you edit the HTML for just that individual block. Or, if you want to edit the HTML for your entire post, you can access the code editor from the main Tools and Options dropdown. Or, you can also just use the keyboard shortcut to toggle between code and visual editing. Control, Shift, Alt, M. Keep in mind that in the full code editor, you have to work around all the markup for blocks. If you're still using the classic WordPress editor, you can edit HTML for your entire post by going to the Text tab. Now let's get to the bigger topic, which is how to edit code in your WordPress theme. The stakes are a little bit higher, so we need to cover a few preliminary questions before we get into the how-to. Why are the stakes higher? Well, quite simply, it's because you can break your site if you mess something up here. In recent releases, WordPress has made it a lot harder for you to accidentally do this. But editing the source code of your site is always going to open the door to issues, so you want to make sure to do it safely. And don't forget to back up your WordPress site before editing your code. If you plan to directly edit any of the code in your theme's files, you should use a child theme rather than editing the parent theme. Without a child theme, any code changes that you make will be overwritten the next time you update your theme. When you use a child theme, however, you'll be able to promptly update the parent theme without losing the changes you've made in your child theme. If you're planning to modify how your theme works, you'll likely need to work by directly editing your child theme's source code. However, if you want to edit code in WordPress for a different reason, like adding a tracking script to the head section of your site, or adding a snippet to your theme's functions file, you might be better off using a plugin instead. For example, the head, footer, and post injections make it easy to inject code snippets where needed. And because these code snippets are all segregated into the plugin's interface, it's also easier to manage them in the future. Similarly, if you're adding a code snippet that could go into your child theme's functions file, the free Code Snippets plugin makes a great option. If you're planning to edit your theme's code directly, we highly recommend that you make a backup of your site before doing so, either of your entire site or the file you're editing. Once you've done that, you can access the in-dashboard theme code editor by going to Appearance and then Theme Editor. Here, WordPress will give you a warning. Then you'll be able to use the sidebar on the right to navigate between different theme files and the code editor itself to make your actual edits. As an alternative to the in-dashboard code editor, you can also edit theme files via SFTP. There are two benefits to this approach. You can use your preferred code editor, or if you accidentally break something, you can fix the issue right away. In contrast, if you edit code via your WordPress dashboard, there's always a chance that you could break something that locks you out of your WordPress dashboard, which means you need to connect via SFTP to fix the issue. Here's how to connect to your site via FTP. Once you've done that, navigate to your themes folder, WP Content, Themes, and then your child theme name. Find the file that you want to edit and right-click on it. Most FTP programs will give you an option to edit the file and will automatically re-upload the file once you make your changes. However, we highly recommend that you download an original version of the file to your desktop before making any changes. That way, you can just re-upload that original version if you accidentally break something. The easiest and most convenient way to access your CSS style sheet is right in the WordPress dashboard. No need to install FTP programs or code editors. You can directly edit any file with syntax highlighting and function documentation built in. Before you do any major edits to core files, you should always backup your WordPress site. It's very easy to accidentally make a mistake that could break your site's appearance if you're new to CSS, and it could be difficult to figure out how to revert your changes. Once you've made a backup and a child theme, log into your backend. You can find the editor by going to the menu and clicking Appearance, and then Theme Editor. You should see a pop-up warning you against making direct edits to these files. Don't worry, just click I understand. It's only a warning to use a child theme and backup your website before you make any major changes. Follow those steps, and it's safe to edit. And now you're in. You should be on the style sheet by default, but look to the menu on the right to view your theme files if not. Besides style.css, you also have access to template files like functions.php, header.php, and single.php. All of these affect how certain pages on your site act, but you should familiarize yourself with PHP before diving into those particular files. Just remember, most CSS changes you make here will be global. For instance, if you change your H1 headers to a certain font, it will take effect for every single page on your site. You need to use special syntax to customize specific pages' styling. What if you can't access the theme editor or prefer to do your work over FTP? It's easier to use the backend editor, but some themes or plugins may disable it. If that's the case, you'll need to connect to your website through FTP. FTP, or File Transfer Protocol, allows you to remotely access and modify a website's files. The first thing you need to do is download FileZilla or another FTP client. Next, you should contact your host and ask for your FTP credentials. If your host has a dashboard, you might be able to find them by logging in. Kinsta users' credentials are located in the My Kinsta dashboard under Sites and then SFTP SSH. Once you have them, launch your FTP client and enter that information. If it doesn't work, try putting SFTP:// before the URL in the host section. Once you're in, you can find your style.css file by clicking the WP Content folder to open it, then your Themes folder, then scrolling until you see style.css. Double-click to open it and make your modifications. Remember to save and upload back to the server. If you need to edit other template files like home.php, single.php, or archive.php, you can find them in the same folder as style.css. Editing your theme files, whether through FTP or the dashboard, isn't always necessary. In fact, it's better to avoid doing it if you're just adding some extra code. If you only want to add custom CSS to WordPress rather than editing WordPress's HTML or PHP code, you don't need to use the in-dashboard code editor or SFTP methods. Instead, you can use the WordPress customizer. Beyond being a simpler option, another benefit of going with this approach is that you'll be able to preview your changes in real time. To get started, go to Appearance and then Customize in your WordPress dashboard. Then, look for the additional CSS option in the WordPress Customizer. That will open a code editor where you can add your desired CSS. As you add CSS, the live preview of your site will automatically update according to those changes. Another good option for adding CSS is the Simple CSS plugin from Tom Usborne. It gives you a similar option in the WordPress Customizer, and it also lets you add custom CSS to individual posts or pages via the meta box. Finally, if you want to add a ton of custom CSS, like hundreds or thousands of lines, another option is to create your own custom CSS style sheet and use WP and Q scripts to add it to your theme. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.